Okay, hello friends, this is Rainer again. You will be surprised, just a bit more than a week after the latest video and I'm back. But I have to explain a bit about last week's episode. So, let me see. Let's change the view a bit. You remember last week I told you that I am looking for a new job. That's of course something I really have to do. And you also remember my great idea about this. Now we say life improvement by a reasonable productivity attitude. So now you should think what last week was, because I mean you can read this in that direction, but you can also read it in that direction. So you see that is April, because I was getting up on Monday morning, April 1st at 5:30 a.m. in the morning. It was dark outside and I was saying, okay, I have to upload this video so that it goes online on April 1st and the people will see it and smile at it. And then, yeah, how to say, fooling me, fooling you. YouTube was fooling me. If you look at the video, it said online on the 31st of March, but I really uploaded it in the early morning of the April 1st. But of course, it looks like YouTube is time zone California. That's Germany is 9 hours ahead of California, so in California it was still March 31st. Well, anyway, this video was partially supposed to be an April Fool's joke. So of course I'm not exaggerating. I mean, I'm really thinking about my future. That's not a joke. It's really serious that my firm is closing and I have to think how to go on. I have a lot of offers, so I'm not worried at all. But I'm also thinking how I can improve my org mode system. And you remember last week I told you about org procrastinate with some great features, like I'm mailing excuses to people that wait for me and so on. Of course, that was part of the April 1st Fool's Day joke. But on the other hand, a lot of the people that commented on the last video, they told already the truth that they said, hey, there is that org scatter bulk function where you can just mark some entries in your agenda and you say scatter and you put it to someday in the future. That's a good idea, really, and I'm using this already. I'm also using extensively org reschedule, so whenever I see a task where I say, okay, there was a task, let's say work in the garden and it's raining cats and dogs, then I say, okay, let me schedule this for next week. And the task is rescheduled for next week. But of course, with all the scattering and rescheduling, we have some problems. Because whenever I do this, I am shooting practically into the blue. I have no idea how much occupied the target date is already. I mean, you just see your small calendar view that says those are the dates, but you don't see how much tasks you have already allocated on that date. So my current workaround for this, since I'm not so much experienced in Emacs programming, I have a scheduled item for my weekly review that says, okay, at the end of all your planning, you call an agenda view and you look 2 and 3 weeks into the future and you see how crowded the days are. And if they are too crowded, you have to reschedule something before you reach that day. And then you find out, oh my God, this is really totally overfilled, so I have to reschedule it on that day. That's the easy workaround that I have. But of course, my wish list, maybe I achieve enough programming skills for Emacs Lisp that I can do that is a sort of a target calendar that somehow indicates that how much tasks are already scheduled for this date where I want to put the next reschedule target. That would make life a bit easier. On the other hand, we also should think about procrastination. I mean, it's something that we all have to confess. It happens frequently, at least in my case. It's not only the I should work in the garden, but now it's raining. It's also, oh, you should do the taxes, or you should clean up that wardrobe or whatever. Those are the tasks. When you look at your org file, you see a lot of tasks that have a lot of lines in the log that always say rescheduled on that date to that date and so on. And at the end, you have to ask yourself, will the task be ever done? Or am I just pushing it forward to whatever day? But I'm really not doing it. For what reason ever? I mean, this is something I really want to consider now in my next weeks, how I can do this better, because it's of no use when you have a task that got rescheduled 20 times. Then you really have to think, am I doing this or am I canceling this, because I won't do it at all. If I have pushed it 20 times into the future, I will push it another 20 times into the future, but then it's of no use to have it in your org mode system. Or you have to think, why am I pushing it? What are the reasons? Maybe it's a reason that you say, okay, I have a task, let's say paint something in the house or paint the garage or whatever, and you push it into the future, because when the day comes, when you scheduled it, you find out, oh, I forgot to buy the tools and the color. And then you should schedule a task that says go to a shop and buy paint and buy color and buy brushes. And then when you have that, this is the prerequisite that you can do your painting job. There's no need to schedule it for any day when you are not ready to do it. So this is one of the reasons. But at the moment, when I do my weekly reviews, it's really I'm taking my org file, and then I look at every task that I have, and I look at the log file, and then I see, oh, there are five or six or whatever rescheduled entries, and then I start thinking, what can I do with this task? And also here I have a wish list. I would like some some org mode extension that creates a property like let's call it reschedule count, and a hook that whenever I update a task and I reschedule it somehow from one day to the next, this count just gets incremented by one. And then I would like an agenda view that says, okay, show me the tasks that are always rescheduled, so that I have one view and I can concentrate and I can focus and say, okay, let me see the first task, let's say 10 times rescheduled, what is it? Is it really worth to keep it in the system, or can we throw it out because we maybe won't do it at all? Or what is the damage if we don't do it, or how urgent it is, or whatever? So this are my two real, it's not an April Fool's joke anymore, these are my two real concerns at the moment, why I think I could improve my system. When I have those functions or those methods that I say, okay, org mode is helping me really a lot to keep my day organized, but I see that friction that you've hit days where you find the task that you say, oops, this one was scheduled for today, but I have no energy, I have no tools, I have whatever reason, I push it in the future, and this should get better somehow. So I hope you are not mad at me because I was doing that April Fool's joke. I just wanted to come back somehow on YouTube, and then I had the great idea, oh, April 1st is coming, I could do a video with some jokes, maybe you smile at it. And yeah, I will see what I can do for the other things, I mean, you were already posting some good ideas in the comments, but whenever you have an idea or you say, well, we need something more, or we should show me how you do it now, because, I mean, since I was recording the last tutorial video, I guess I had, oh, let me think. There was some changes in my system, so now I have some small lines of Elisp code so that I can copy-paste tasks from the agenda to my daily schedule file and so on. If you want to see that, I could record a video on that. So, but that's all for now. I hope you enjoyed, even if it was sort of bad news for the people that are waiting for Procrastinate that won't come, but maybe some other features in my mind I can realize with the limited Elisp skills that I have, but maybe they improve as well. I just have to see that I carve out some time. At the moment I'm still busy in my job, but if this is gone, maybe I have some extra time to get new skills and how to say, some new features for my system. So thanks for watching, and next time I will see what I can present you. Stay tuned.